Okay, guys, lesson number two. Now we're going to start looking at slipping. Okay, so slipping punches and sometimes kicks, but mostly slipping punches is all about moving yourself off the center line. Okay, moving your head specifically off the center line. One big mistake we see with slipping is people will move their shoulders but not move their head. And what happens is the head stays pretty much in the same spot. So we want to keep everything fairly rigid so your spine is more or less straight and let everything move together when we're doing our slip motion. There is two sides we can slip to. There's the closed side, which is over your lead leg, and the open side slip, which is over your back leg, okay? And I specifically use the word over your leg because there's nothing over in this space here in front of me if I slip to it. This is a really common mistake people make. They try and slip into this space forward and they've got no balance, okay? You wanna make sure the majority of your slips, with one or two exceptions, the majority of your slips are gonna be towards your legs because that is where your base is. You have the ability to be athletic from this position, whether it's to come back with shots of your own, right? Whether it's up jabs or hooks, you know, potentially use it to actually load yourself for something like an overhand or even just a really nicely drilled cross, okay? You can incorporate this head movement into your basic punches. I always want to be over my leg. That's the long and the short of it. So whenever we do our slip motion, we want to make sure our head moves over the knee, okay, of the leg that we're trying to slip to, and we want to make sure we propel our opposite shoulder forward slightly. This creates an athletic position for us to unwind from. If I keep my shoulders here and I slip like this, I'm not in an athletic position and a stiff breeze is gonna knock me over this way. So I need to make sure I keep my stance, slip, load the shoulder, and I'm able to recover back into my position straight away. When you're practicing this as part of your shadow boxing, again, stay on your toes, work on your stance, work on your general movements, and then every now and again, just work a small slip. A really good habit to get into is to get into the habit of stepping forward or back when you slip. Because a lot of the time the slip is designed to get you into range, but if you're not covering distance with your feet as well, that can be very tough, okay? Specifically work forward and back. Another big mistake we see with slips is people will step in the direction that they are slipping. That's two tools to do the one job. It's not necessary. It takes too much time, it's too much weight transferring to that side. If I'm gonna step like this, all right, I'm actually moving myself away from the target too much. I wanna keep my shoulders close enough that I can fire back. So when you slip, try to make sure the movement, if there is any, is going to be forward or backwards, rather than side to side, okay? Keep those feet on that line. This is the benefit of head movement. It allows you to travel straight to your partner without traveling straight into their fists with your face, okay? So we wanna move in, into a slip position. We can work from there and start to throw our shots. Likewise, I might defensively move back, but I'm in an athletic position now that I'm loaded. If someone's coming over the top of me, I can work the body and the head, or I can potentially drill them with a counter cross as well, all right? Or in an MMA sense, we could be back into a slip position. That becomes a level change for a double leg, all right? So hopefully you find that helpful. Work that into your shadow boxing as well. Again, basic footwork is the most important thing. After that, we're gonna start looking at how we can add in the head movements to create your counter opportunities. Go for it.